So source working memory now contains all the things that we had in the previous shot. Some of these things are percepts. Some of the things are the picture's internal goals. Let us see how the contents of the working memory now invoke different kinds of knowledge from the long-term memory. So let us imagine that the procedural part of source long-term memory contains the following rules. The procedural knowledge in source long-term memory is represented in the form of rules. This is sometimes called production rules. In fact, the term production systems comes from the term production rules. So each rule here is a production rule. I have shown 7 here, there could be more rules. Once again, these production rules are capturing the procedural knowledge in source long-term memory. Recall that one of the first things that the pitcher had to decide was whether the pitcher should throw a pitch or walk the batter. Therefore, we assume that there are some rules which allow the pitcher to make a decision between these two choices. Thus, there is a rule here, if the goal is to escape, and I perceive 2 outs, and I perceive on the second, and I perceive a runner on the second, and I perceive no runner on the first base, then I may suggest the goal of intentionally walk batter. Here is another rule. The second rule says, if the goal is to escape, and I perceive 2 outs, and I perceive a runner on the first base, or I perceive no runner on the second, or I perceive no runners, then suggest the goal to get the batter out via pitching. Now what might happen if I pick the goal of intentionally walking the batter? The goal is to intentionally walk the batter, then suggest intentional walk operator. Now this intentional walk operator corresponds to some action available in the world. And similarly, the other rules. Let's consider one other rule. Rule number 7, if only one operator has been selected, then send the operator to the motor system and add the pitch thrown to the state. So there is now both an action has been selected, and the action is going to be executed, as well as the state of the working memory is going to change, so it will say that now the pitch has been thrown. Before we go ahead, let me summarize what we just learned. Source long-term memory consists of various kinds of knowledge. One kind of knowledge, the one that we are considering right now, is procedural knowledge. Procedural knowledge is about how to do something. And so, procedural knowledge is represented in the form of production rules. Each production rule is of the form, if something, then something. There are antecedents and there are consequences. These antecedents may be connected through various kinds of relationships like and or. The consequence, too, might be connected through various kinds of relationships like and or. So I may have if some antecedent is true and some other antecedent is true and so on, then do some consequent. Now that we understand a little bit about the representation of production rules, what about the content? What should be the content that we put into these production rules? Earlier we had said that cognitive architectures are goal-oriented. So we will expect goals to appear in some of the production rules. Indeed, they do. R1, R2, R3, and so on. Earlier we had said that knowledge-based AI, cognitive systems, use a lot of knowledge. And you can see how detailed and specific this knowledge is. In fact, the knowledge is so detailed and specific that in principle we can hope that as different percepts come from the world, some rule is available that will be useful for that set of percepts.